I hear my dad coming.
Yes.
Oh, good.
I wanted to give my seat to my dad because you'll love to talk to him.
Oh, is it Santa Claus coming?
Come in here. Come in here. Pop, come in here.
Action, camera.
Action. He loves it.
Yeah. I can't wait.
Pick up on Eugenie. They were asking about where she was raised and about her life.
Oh, okay. That's very simple.
That's very simple?
Yeah.
Why don't you tell them about me when I was little?
The zip code is 06831. That's one of the most distinguished zip codes in America. I left St. Louis with my wife 69 years ago because I had too many girlfriends. So my wife wanted me to live in New York, work for a bank, very conservative. And then I discovered the Pitchfork Ranch, which I fell in love with. Okay. And then came along Jim Humphreys, our manager, who adopted Eugenie, and he was the president of the Pitchfork Ranch. Then he came along because he could waltz. That's all he had, because he waltzed. And he came into my room with my wife in May, some month.
Yeah.
I want to marry your daughter. I says, no, you're not going to marry my daughter. No way you're going to marry my daughter unless you come to New York.
True story.
Uh-huh. I'm going to throw him out quickly.
No, he's saying it in a nice way.
So he comes to New York, dressed just like that, with a toothpick in his mouth. They all thought he was Cary Grant or something. No, John Wayne. Yes, ma'am. No, ma'am. And then he cried every day. Not cried, but he had to call his father every day because he didn't know what the East was all about.
They had dances back then, you know, between Rhineland and Benjamin, Texas, in the summertime. It was back and forth.
Every other week.
Every other week. So this cowboy comes walking in who I'd been running with. His name was Randy Reed. And he'd been drinking a little bit. And he comes over and he's very, very shy, even shyer than I was. And I was very shy myself. He said, there's these two girls from the Pitchfork that are here. I'd like to dance with one of them, but I'm too embarrassed to ask. You'll have to ask for me. I said, I'll do that, but I get my pick. And so that's how it started. Then about that time, Eugenie walks in with Jane Humphreys. And I mean, Janie's like, when she walks in, it's like a light lighting up. I mean, you're attracted to her because of her personality. And I was immediately attracted to her. I didn't even give Jane a chance. Eugenie walked in and I said, Randy, that's my girl right there. And we danced all night long. And I got Eugenie's address in Greenwich, Connecticut. And I wrote her a letter there, and we wrote back and forth two or three times. And I saw her again at Pitchfork Horse Sale in October of 81, when she came down for a Pitchfork Horse Sale. She wrote me a letter and told me she was coming. The owner of the Morehouse Ranch, Tom Morehouse, told me, he says, okay, you can have off one day. Pick which one you want to go to. And I said, the Pitchfork. I'm going to go to the Pitchfork Ranch because I knew Eugenie would be there.
I went to their family's home, and they wanted to drink a martini at home before we came. I said, no, we'll meet the family and be respectful. We walked in, met her mother's sister. What would you like? Iced tea? We looked at each other. This is going to be awful. So we
water,
had the iced
water
tea.
Water and iced tea.
But then he saved us. We met Uncle Ed.
Uncle Ed, we were at the bachelor party.
Yeah, bachelor party. In the back, they had a goat. We never saw a goat.
And a barbecue.
And beer.
And beer.
And cake.
So that saved the day. But these people are so good. They're all Baptists, you know, and they all tell the truth. That's the problem. But from there on, it was great. And I've never been happier in my life. So here we are together.